Today we're going to create our own slightly different example of the Arduino crystal ball. This is similar to the Arduino starter kit example project 11 crystal ball, and if you purchased that Arduino starter kit, you may have created the project, the crystal ball. But this one will be slightly different, like I just said. One difference is that we will be replacing the 16x2 LCD screen here, the LCD display, with an I2C or I2C LCD display. This is a 20x4, this one's a 16x2, and you'll also be swapping out the tilt sensor right here. It's got a metal ball in it, and once it turns, that metal ball breaks the connection between the two pins on the bottom. Well, we're not going to use this. We're going to replace it with the infrared obstacle avoidance sensor module, and this is HW201. It's the one I'm using, and you can control the distance that it can read by turning this potentiometer right here. So it can go to about 3 feet, I believe, and as close as a couple inches. So we'll be using this. I've got it connected right here. Aside from these two items, all you'll need are just a couple of these jumper cables, an Arduino Uno, and a breadboard. The infrared sensor has three pins. It has a data out pin, a ground, and a VCC. The ground and the VCC are connected right here to the positive and negative rails of the breadboard, and the data out pin is connected to pin 6 on the Uno. The I2C LCD display has four pins, two of which are up here connected to the Arduino Uno at the SCL pin and the SDA pin. And then the other two pins are connected to the positive and negative rail, which is 5 volts for the positive rail here on the breadboard. And then the breadboard, positive and negative rails are connected to the 5 volt pin and the ground pin of the Uno. Here's a wiring diagram in case you had any questions about the connections. The example code for the crystal ball should already be preloaded into your Arduino IDE. So if you go up to File, go to Examples, and then come down here to Starter Kit, Basic Kit. I believe that's already preloaded. I didn't install this or download it. So you just go here, go down to number 11, crystal ball, click on that, and this is what you'll get. And it's kind of nice the way they set it up here. It tells you exactly what you need. They're using a 220 ohm resistor, a 10K resistor, 10K potentiometer, the 16x2 LCD screen, and a tilt switch. As you scroll down through the rest of it, you can see that they are setting up their LCD display, and they're using a random switch case to determine what the ball says. But if you want to set this up with fewer wires connected to your LCD display, and where you scan your hand over it instead of having to tilt it back and forth, well, I guess the Magic 8 Ball, you would shake it, but this one's more kind of like a crystal ball, right? You just swish your hand over top of that, and it tells you the answer to whatever question you're asking. So let's go ahead and take a look at the slight modifications I made to this code. And if we switch back over to the original code, I left it all the same, but I made changes here. Like, you don't need the 220 ohm resistor. You don't need the 10K resistor. You don't need the 10K potentiometer, which is a variable resistor. And you don't need the 16x2 LCD screen. We're using the I2C or I2C LCD display. And we're not using the tilt switch. As fun as that is to use, we are going to use the IR sensor for hands-free crystal ball. And if you scroll down here, you can see some changes that I made. I included the liquid crystal I2C library. And then right here, I changed this line to the I2C address of the display. And if you don't know how to get that, I have a video on that that I'll include in the description below. And if we come down here, I left the switch pin the same. That was already there. And that is the pin 6 of my IR sensor. So I just left that there and used that. Scroll down here, I set up the I2C display here. And if you move down here to the loop, I believe I have left everything the same as it was. So those are the only changes that I had to make. Not too bad. So I will include this code on the Facebook page if you're interested. And if I want to ask my Arduino crystal ball any questions, I just swipe my hand over top of this IR sensor here. Again, you can adjust it with the potentiometer here on the front. I just swipe my hand over it and say, is this going to get a million views? Most likely. Well, that's great. So you just ask it any question you want, and it will give you whatever random answers you decide to put into your code. and you can change those. Another change that you can make to this is you can change what the crystal ball says. You can just change this string right here that's printed to your LCD display, and you can make it whatever you want. You can also add more or delete some of these. So it starts with case 0, switch case 0, all the way up to 7. That's a total of 8, but whatever you make that number, you need to change it here. If you add 2 more, you make that a 10. If you take 2 of these comments away, 2 of these cases away, you're going to make that a 6, and so forth. So this is just a way to have a little fun and add variety to your example codes with slight modifications to the code. Hopefully you find it useful. That's it for this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you're interested in this. Also, don't forget to check out the description below for other helpful videos that I'll link in the description as it pertains to this. So was this a good video? Most likely. All right, we'll go with that. Thank you, Crystal Ball. All right, we'll see you again very soon.